I now have Steven Rose here, Program Manager for OneDrive for Business, and I'm so happy that you're here. Welcome, Steven.
It's great to see you, Raymond. I've known you for years, so it's awesome to see you in this role and doing all this, so it's great to be here today.
Yeah, sure. I'm happy as well. OneDrive for Business, I've seen a shipload of announcements around this product. You must have been really, really, really busy in the past few weeks.
Yeah, our engineering teams have done a great job on getting a lot of the new features ready for Ignite that people have through user voice that they've wanted and our customers have wanted. So it's been a great week sharing with everybody here.
And there is one big blog post that announces all the new stuff in OneDrive for Business. It's on the tech community.
Yep.
And I wanted to highlight a few of them.
Yeah.
There are some new features in there that really caught my attention. Especially the ones that have better Windows integration, like StorageSense integration. Can you tell us what that's about?
Yeah, coming with the upcoming release this fall, Files on Demand is going to be part of StorageSense. So an administrator can say after a certain amount of days or when a hard drive gets to a certain amount of fullness that, hey, offload this content back to the cloud. So what's great is the end user, because it's Files on Demand, can still search whether it's in the cloud or local, but it's going to get those documents you haven't used and you could set it for every 24 hours. Every day, every week, month, whatever. So you can pick what that right time is to make sure that you don't have hard drives that get too full and that the content that's on those devices are the ones that the folks are using on a regular basis. So that'll be a great piece, great part of RS5 when that comes out.
Cool. So it's almost like what we have in mail already. You haven't touched that email for a while. It gets offloaded to an archive. And now it's with OneDrive. You haven't touched some files for a while and they get offloaded to the cloud. So that
will be moved. Yeah, they're already local. So what we're going to do is we're going to remove the local cache copy so that it's only now in the cloud. And if any changes get made there, it's always up to date. And the moment you click it, you'll stream down a new version. So yeah, absolutely.
Okay. And then there's also a lot of news on the mobile front. I see Office Lens integration, new artificial intelligence built in OneDrive. Can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Yeah, we've had Office Lens built into our scan capabilities, but what we've done is on iOS and Android, we've now made it a dedicated button. We support business card, multi-page document scanning, whiteboard scanning, and you can go back in once you scan, name it, it's automatically saved in OneDrive. You can draw on it, add notes to it, do whatever you want. But some of the cool things now is how we brought intelligence into that. So if we take a look at like a meeting scenario, before you walk into a meeting, you can hover over a file or take a look at the information that will give you things like, how long is this file going to take to read? So you can decide, do I want to read this now or later? If you share it with a group of people, it'll actually tell you who's read that file. So you can actually say before my meeting, if I'm going to meet with five people, 4 out of 5 have read this, or only 1 out of 5 have read this, and you may have to change your course. Also, when you get that document, you can hover over and you can see key points. So we'll tell you, here are the key things that are covered within this document. And we do that all through intelligence. What's great is throughout Office and in OneDrive Mobile, that if you take a picture of the whiteboard, if you create a PowerPoint or you're showing a PowerPoint in a meeting, it'll actually ask you, do you want to share this with the people who are in the meeting with you? Because it's fully integrated through the graph and taking a look at your exchange and your Outlook and say, yeah, you were in a meeting with these people. If you took a picture of a whiteboard, it was part of that, and ask if you automatically want to share. And then you just hit yes. Everybody is automatically put into the line. You just add your text, you share it out, and you're ready to go. So we're bringing that intelligence capabilities into mobile, into desktop, and really across the whole OneDrive suite.
That sounds really cool. I'm really ready to give this a try. There's also, OneDrive is not only Windows. It's on iOS, it's on Android, it's even on Mac OS, and there is much enthusiasm among the Mac OS users because we now have integration for offline files. The
Files on Demand, yeah.
Files on Demand. So why is that such a huge thing?
Well, I think that there's a few things. When we take a look at the core pillars of OneDrive, one is that ability to be able to work anywhere from any device. So, and we know that people just don't use one device. They may be using an iPhone or an Android device. They may have an iPad or an Android tablet. They may have a Mac. They may have a PC. What's great is once their content gets into the cloud, they should be able to move from device to device and have that same experience. And that's the thing that we've been working for, is ubiquity across Office, across OneDrive, across SharePoint. So by bringing files on demand to Mac, and that's something we had to work with Apple on, and it's deeply integrated into the operating system, you now can have that same experience as PC. The client, the sharing experience is the same, and now you can have that same online, offline. So as you move back and forth through your day, you can do what you need to do. And it's interesting because as I take a look at, you know, you and I are a little bit older, but as we look at kids, you know, like your kids' age, my kids' age, and, you know, some of the millennials and things, they don't see a difference between a phone, a laptop, and a tablet. They just see it as a way to get to their stuff. They live in this everything is in the cloud world, and I get that, and that's awesome. But the thing is, that experience has to be the same as you move through all those different endpoints. So it's trying to make sure that our customers that still want to do everything on their device have a great experience. Those people who want to do it only in the cloud have a great experience. And the folks who want to move back and forth can do that same thing, and that it works the same way. And I think we've done a really good job of getting to that point for all of our users across all operating systems.
Well, that's for sure. I like the part about the millennials who look at things different than we do. Nice. Is there one specific feature that's your favorite for this time of the year?
I think there's a lot. I think our focus where it really was for the past few years about really getting the sync client rock solid and creating a great experience. Now it's about intelligence and making things smarter. We've brought some of the Stream and Azure APIs into OneDrive and SharePoint, so we now support real-time transcription, being able to search by keywords, find what you're looking for. So now it's really, now that you've got your stuff in the cloud, how do we harness that power? How do we make it a really great, smart experience for you? How can we start to anticipate what you're going to need and make sure you have it, and then also surface up things you didn't know that you need? We don't want to just say, hi, you're doing this, so you want this. I don't want that Amazon experience that says, if I order a toaster, I must also need new tennis shoes, that type of thing where you're like, how do those two go together? But what we want is, hey, if you're about to walk into a meeting, here's what other people have been working on. Here's what's probably important to you. Here is the ability to search across all of your media files to find the ones that are relevant. So it's bringing that relevant content and surfacing up, which help people to work smarter and better and faster. And that's so important.
And this is also what we can anticipate for the future when we're looking at OneDrive next year? Or isn't there anything you can share with us about that right now?
What I can say is that user voice drives nearly one out of every three innovations that we do. So we're going to continue to look at user voice as we balance evolution and revolution, what people want and need versus what they didn't know and they wanted and even needed, and try to balance that. But our end users are critical. And we're going to listen to them on what we built this year, what's great, what could be better, what new scenarios have been uncovered with this that offers new opportunities for businesses. We're going to listen to them closely, and we're going to rev on that. So we always have great stuff. And, you know, May at the SharePoint Conference in North America will be our next big moment. We'll do some great announcements there. We have things that we're working on. We've had great conversations with customers and MVPs this week. Summit will come up. I'm sure you guys will give us a lot of feedback at MVP Summit. We're reading into the blogs and all that. So we're going to take a look at all that. And I always like to say, if we have a dollar to spend, where do we want to spend it? And how do we want to break that down? So we'll take a look at that and figure out how to make the best use of our resources and continue to create a great experience for our users with OneDrive.
Thank you very much. For this interview, I have one extra question that I want to ask today to every of my interviews. This event is also about diversity and tech. And one of the themes is, what's your diversity superpower? I wanted to ask you that question.
What is my diversity superpower? Wow. I think my diversity superpower is that I'm older and I've been in the industry for a long time, 15 years as a consultant. I was an MVP for 3 years. I've been at Microsoft for 10 years. Is I have really learned, and I like to control the conversation a little bit sometimes, but I have really learned to sit back at a table with a wide variety of people of ages and races and creeds and colors. And when I'm in those meetings, I really find some amazing things that folks take a look at because of their background, because of where they came from. And every day I find myself looking at things differently and approaching problems differently and doing that sort of stuff, which is absolutely tremendous. So for me, it is really learning from everybody else and seeing what everybody else is doing, and using that as the guide, just really getting away from my preconceived notions. So that's what it is, and having great friends like you and so many other people who call me on stuff. Hey, that's changed. That's different now. I learned this from my kid. You're not using the right term. So you are my bae. we could say now, which I know means something completely different in Dutch. So that's, see, that's it.
Okay, Stephen, thank you very much. And that brings us to the end of this interview. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll be back.